days before the sale started, yeah. And can't...
Entry form Dave filled out.
Hi, it's Rod, and this one's called Tuning In to God's Truth. I got my shortwave radio here. Let's see what I can tune into.
Days before the sale started, yeah. And camp out.
Entry form Dave filled out.
Well, I can tune into some sales pitches, or I can tune into some music about unimportant things or whatever. Can I tune into God with this shortwave? Probably not. Or if you tuned into Christian Teachings channel on YouTube, you might tune into hearing something from God, because Rod on Christian Teachings is trying to listen to God and teach some truth for him. Type thing. It's like Jesus was trying to tune into God when he was praying and then go and tell his disciples the truth that God was telling him. Our minds are sort of like a radio. We got a tuning knob or whatever. A volume switch. And we get to choose what we're going to listen to in our minds. Are we going to choose to turn it to God's truth FM? Or are we going to turn it to Satan's lies FM? If we're listening to God, we'll follow Him. We'll follow His voice in our mind. And we'll want to tune in to God's truth and turn away from Satan's lies. Most people each day just want to tune into Satan's lies and leave the station on there. I don't want to read the Bible. I don't want to pray. I don't want to get close to God or hear His voice or learn truth in my mind or whatever. Their mind just fills with lies, and they turn up the volume on the lies. Instead of turning the volume up on God's truth. Usually when I'm out of my apartment walking around, I put on a pair of headphones. Put on my little MP3 player, and I put on some Christian music or some Christian, the Bible, or some truth or whatever, and I listen to tune into God's truth or whatever. I could be in the grocery store and they could be blasting godless music like they usually do. I don't have to really focus on it. I can focus on some great truth teaching. I listen to my own teachings a lot because I try to listen to God and He tries to teach truth through me, and I can learn stuff from listening to my own teachings or whatever, or other Christians' teachings or Christian music or whatever. What you choose to tune into, well, Satan's trying to get us to tune into his lies and stuff like that and focus in on that all day and turn up the volume on Satan's lies. God's trying to get us to tune into His truth and turn up the volume on His truth instead. It's our choice. One way we can tune into God's truth is to read His Bible. When I read the Bible, I'm not just reading a book. I'm picking up some words that God tried to communicate to His creation man. And I'm listening to God's voice. I'm tuning into His Spirit's voice. Teach me something as I read this word. I could be picking up a worldly magazine or something like that and tuning into Satan's lies or whatever. But I want to pick up God's word and tune into His truth instead. It's like I love to pray. I love to climb into a hot bathtub, turn out the lights, and seek God with all my heart, and find Him. and listen to him and talk to him and hear what he's trying to tell me. I don't have cable TV. I couldn't care less about Satan's TV and what he has to say on there. I do have the internet, and clicking around with a mouse on the internet's like a lot like tuning a radio station or whatever. You're searching for something to listen to or to view or something like that with the eyes or the ears or whatever. Usually it's not something that's full of God's truth. It's full of Satan's lies. You can use any kind of media thing, a radio. You can tune it into a Christian station or something like that, or turn it into a satanic worldly station or whatever. The Illuminati broadcasting station, which is most TV channels and most radio stations. It's really hard to find somebody speaking some truth somewhere. It's like on YouTube or whatever, all them different YouTube video channels, it's hard to find a good Christian teaching some truth on it. And most people in this world are not interested whatsoever in watching the Christian truth videos. They're not interested in God. If you're interested in God, you pray a lot. If you're interested in God, you tune your radio or your, I don't think there's any much on TV, to some truth of God. You pick up the Bible. And then it's like Jesus was tuning into God's truth station. I'm going to pray. I'm going to go talk to God. I'm going to listen to him teach me something. I'm going to go teach that to other people, disciples or whatever. Learn truth from God, teach truth from God, tune into God's truth, and try to teach other people how to tune into God's truth, to listen to God's voice themselves, to pray themselves, to read the Bible themselves, to teach God's truth to others themselves or whatever. We're supposed to be training people to do that. How to pray, how to study the Bible, how to teach God's truth to others, the greatest career on earth or whatever, which brings forth the greatest career in heaven. Jesus came to show us how to live a successful life. We need to look into the Bible. What did God in the flesh choose to do while he was here on earth that pleased his Father in heaven? Well, he prayed a lot. I don't think he had a hot bathtub to do it in, or a sore back or whatever, but he would kneel down and he would pray a lot. And God would talk to him, sort of like Moses by a burning bush. And Jesus would learn things from God, and then he'd go about trying to teach the people of the world what he was hearing from God. He was tuning in to God's truth. Our minds are like a radio station. We can tune them into Satan's Lies FM or God's Truth FM. We're deciding. We wake up in the morning. The demons and Satan are trying to speak to us, trying to get us to, hey, listen to what we have to say. We're going to teach you lies today. We want you to turn on that TV or that surf around on the internet and listen to somebody telling you lies and tell you to believe in those lies. Turn to the atheist station on the internet and listen to their lies, which are inspired by the demons. Or they may tell you to switch, click around the mouse to some good Christian video teaching site and listen to some great truth or whatever. If you're following God's voice of truth instead of Satan's voice of lies. It's also about the friends you choose to hang around with. We're supposed to have like a church and a bunch of Christian friends and stuff like that to be a part of and talk about Jesus and truth all the time with them, but that doesn't happen a whole lot. Most of the time we're talking to people that don't know God and don't know any truth and love to tune their mind to Satan's lies. People full of terrible emotions, people full of terrible words, and that's where they've chosen to tune their mind to. They've just let Satan tell them lies and they choose to believe it's true. They're slaves of Satan and the demons. You try to correct them, say, well, my mind is tuned to God's word and God's voice and that's wrong and this is right and this is the way to be successful. And they say, no, I don't believe that. I think my sinful way, my lie-filled way is the right choice instead. I want to be an atheist or whatever because the demons tell me that's the best choice for me and I got my mind tuned to their demon lies FM radio station. Becoming a Christian is about choosing to switch stations on your mind radio. Stop putting it on Satan's Lies FM. There is no God. You don't need to get saved. You're a good person. All that kind of lies against the truth. And switch it to God's Truth FM. I'm a sinner from birth, from Adam and Eve. Just like His Bible tells me. Just like His Holy Spirit tells me. And I need to be saved through the cross of His Son, Jesus Christ. I need the blood of Jesus to cover all my sins, to take all my sins away. For the forgiveness of all of my sins. And then I can get close to a holy, sin-hating God, which sin separates me from. Like Adam found out when he sinned against God. Jesus came to reconcile us to God. To take away the separation that our sins from birth have been bringing towards God. As soon as you put faith in the truth, it works. If you keep doubting in the truth, it doesn't work for you. For God so loved the world that whoever believes in that will have their sins taken away, type thing. Those who do not believe that Jesus was real or that He died on a cross to take their sins away, they don't have their sins taken away. They're still separated from God. They don't hear His voice clearly. They don't have their mind radio tuned into God through faith, through salvation, through the forgiveness of sins, through the believing that Jesus died on the cross to take all your sins away. God has given us a free will choice. He's given us control of the tuning knob. What do you want to listen to, Rod? Satan's Lies FM today or My Truth FM today, God's saying, or whatever. And we decide. So thank you, Father, for trying to help me and other people to understand how we can tune into Your truth like You want us to. And how we can stop tuning our minds to Satan's lies and sin and destruction. So we can be what You want us to be. More like Jesus, who tuned His mind to Your truth. In the name of Your Son, Jesus, I ask You to. Amen.
John 3:16. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life.